considered the most crucial day of the Christmas festive season is over, and that's the 25th of December. And the whole season will also be over soon. And we have the economy set to reopen, but I want to know, what have you got planned for the new year and the reopening of the economy? I really hope that you have got your resolutions made, and we shall meet in the new year. Welcome to the Business Show.
Once the economy starts to move, the money supply starts to run on its wheels, you'll see the banking sector waking up, people start to take loans, credit, people start to pay back.
So if you want to venture into dairy farming, you have to be patient.
Welcome. After 2 years of COVID-19 and of closure of the economy, plus a curfew and lockdowns that affected businesses and even led some to close, we have had a good message now from the president, who announces that next year there is going to be the reopening of the economy. Now, that sounds very good. We have a lot of anticipation in the air, everyone waiting to see how curfew will be lifted, how lockdowns won't happen again, and that could cause opportunities, but how ready are you for them? To avoid any confusion and mistakes that might arise from the reopening of the economy, we have a chat with Stephen Asimwe, and he's supposed to let us know what we should and shouldn't do to be able to welcome the opportunities that are coming with the reopening of the economy.
My name is Stephen Asimwe. I'm the Chief Executive Officer of the Private Sector Foundation of Uganda. The Private Sector Foundation of Uganda is the apex body of private sector associations, federations, and groups that are subscribers to a very good mandate that supports private sector. Our motto is business growth is our business. 2021 has been a very tough year, and at Private Sector Foundation, the catchword now is resilience. But also that came with a devastating effect on the businesses, on enterprises. Many enterprises have closed, unfortunately, because lack of markets, lack of offtakes, people had borrowed money. Everybody suffered. Both supply and demand suffered. The goods were not moving. Services were not being offered, people were laid off jobs, business opportunities shut down, and different planning schemes and schedules were disrupted. So to that extent, economic figures are really evident that the devastating effects of the COVID-19, of the pandemic, left a huge hole in the economy, and you know, taxes suffered. Government programs were hit very hard. But slowly, when the president started to open the economy a bit, we started to see a gradual shift in performance. Slow, steady, but not quite there. So it has been a very, very tough year. And I must confess that those who have managed to survive it have managed by the sheer grace of God. But also, unfortunately, many businesses have had to close, you know, factories, shops, hotels, airlines. I mean, the net effect had a crumbling effect on technically the whole economy. I'm very, very optimistic that with the plan to reopen in 2022, we're going to see, I think, a takeoff. The context that you see, money is like blood supply. Money is like breathing in your lungs. You inhale and exhale. There's give and take, there's supply and demand, and those are the forces that push the wheels of an economy. Just to put it in context, a sector like education suffered massively. Both in terms of the impact it had on the manpower, teachers, on the students who are off-takers, but also education as a business ground to a halt. With the reopening of schools, we feel that 15 million students will get back to school, will create a supply chain mechanism that is going to be off-takers of food, of transport, of stationery, of electricity, of water, of scholastic materials, of literally everything that moves and exists because of a school setting. Similarly, we are going to see a change in travel, which is going to affect the tourism sector positively. All of that has a knock-on effect positively on agriculture, because people will have to grow food, which will be consumed by a population. So people get back to work, production lines will be back into normal, and we'll see the emergence or the resurfacing, especially of the leisure, entertainment industry, education, logistics, trade, financial services. We have a very interesting concept coming, oil and gas from Bulisa in Western Uganda, which is going to build a pipeline from Bulisa area through Mutukula up to Tanga Port in northeast Tanzania. The resumption of travel will obviously catapult tourism back to its heydays, which had been very good. Once the economy starts to move, the money supply starts to run on its wheels, you'll see the banking sector waking up, people start to take loans, credit, people start to pay back unpaid systems. The government will start to get more taxes, and we believe that once the taxes come in into the treasury, money will be paid back to domestic areas, and obviously we'll start to see a resuscitation of the economy back to pre-2019 days, and I'm very, very optimistic that that's going to happen. One of the beneficiaries of the prospects for a positive recovery of the opening up of the economy in 2022 will be the night economy. The night economy in Uganda presents a very large portion of the ecosystem of a good economy in the country. If you look at it in context, you have all the bars, entertainment places, factories, transport, logistics, you have people studying at nights, you have people moving, you have people eating, the leisure industry, the entertainment mostly takes place at night. In the context of the 8-hour shift, most businesses take place during daytime. But in the night, a new group emerges. So people who have been at work basically go into a leisure mode. And leisure mode means the foods and beverages industry, it means the hotel industry, it means transport, security. A lot of factories are at work. And when people are at work, they need services. They need to eat, they need to drink, they need money transfers, forex bureaus, casinos. And that's an integral part of an economy. The leisure, hospitality sector is alive and vibrant, and money changes hands. People are moving to and from various places. The curfew presented a stop to that economy. So if you remember the first lockdown, you were not allowed even to go to town. It was a total shutdown. So literally 90% of that, even the evening economy was down. Come a partial lifting, it was pushed to 7, which has been existent. So that economy literally has been from almost 7 to 5:30. I believe that once the lifting is done, there will be a bigger resuscitation of that economy. Now, to put it again in context, there are some businesses that 100% survive and thrive on the night economy. Anytime someone moves out of his house to another place, means that they will spend money. In tourism, we measure stay and spend, volumes and value. So the quality of spend goes higher, the volumes go higher, people stay longer and spend more money. And obviously, everybody benefits from that. That night economy has been stunted. It has been in a recess. It's been in almost comatose for some of the in different industries. And I believe that that economy is going to get up and run. What I think is very important is to be able to give it some resuscitation in the form of credit. A lot of businesses have suffered. They are in debt. They are lacking capital. They are lacking resource support. Many people have been laid off or even changed jobs. And I believe that that should be able to create a catalyst for free growth. And we've seen it across the world. In Europe, in America, next door, our neighbors, Kenya, had to open because literally tourism accounts for the number one foreign exchange. And same thing with Uganda. Tourism used to account for number one foreign exchange and 10% of GDP. A very, very big employer, directly, indirectly, or induced. So the reopening is certainly going to revive that side, and we should see some resources coming. So Revenue Authority will make money, government will make money, businesses will make money, the country will make money. And so it's a whole supply chain, supply and demand, and all the forces of the economy grows back to life.
The business show continues shortly, but for now we take a break and we shall be right back.